Hey friends, welcome back to Desperation Kids, where we love, learn, and grow together. For the last couple of weeks, we've been talking about the first four commandments. Let's say them together. Are you ready? Love God, no idols, respect God's name, and worship and rest on God's day. Great job, you guys are amazing as always. Okay, this week, we're gonna be learning about the fifth, sixth, and seventh commandments. Are you guys ready? So today's big idea is we obey God by loving our families. But first, we're gonna do our four points of vision, and I know you guys know it, so stand up and let's do it together. Are you ready? Encounter God, experience life change, discover purpose, and change the world. Great job! All right, let's stand up and get ready to encounter God together through worship.
Jesus. Like, okay. Boom! Oh my gosh.
Ready? What's up, kids? I'm Luke.
And I'm Cody. And we're the Dr. Dudes.
Hey, Cody. You want to see something cool?
What is that? He tooted.
All right, kids. So today's game, we got to get these straws into these cups by bouncing them. Let's go.
Do I look like a walrus? Did you explain the game?
Yes, we bounced it.
I don't pay attention sometimes.
Ready, set, go.
Oh. If I can just rapid fire. Oh!
Hey!
All right, guys, 2 out of 3. Let's go again. How about we? Like my AirPods.
It's going straight through my head.
You might have won that round, Cody. All right, let's go.
It looks like you look like Yoda.
And go.
Ah!
Okay. This is annoying. Oh, this is fun, kids. Okay. If you've never checked us out, make sure to like and subscribe to the Dr. Dudes.
Oh!
Here we go. Just rapid fire. I'm not looking at the cup. Yeah. Oh! And dude, I'm not cleaning that up. All right, now we gotta clean up.
Well, hey kids, thanks for hanging out today. Let's lean in and learn about our lesson.
Hey kids, we are on the road for week 3 of our virtual road trip to hear more about the 10 commandments or rules God wants us to live by. Next up, we have commandments 5, 6, and 7. Each of these commandments are about loving people, especially our families. Together, we are gonna read Exodus chapter 20, verses 12 through 14. Honor your father and mother. Then you will live a long, full life in the land the Lord God is giving you. You must not murder. You must not commit adultery. Okay, now we're gonna read Matthew chapter 5, verses 21 through 24. You have heard that our ancestors were told, you must not murder. If you commit murder, you are subject to judgment. But I say, if you are even angry with someone, you are subject to judgment. If you call someone an idiot, you are in danger of being brought before the court. And if you curse someone, you are in danger of the fires of hell. So, if you are presenting a sacrifice at the altar in the temple and you suddenly remember that someone has something against you, leave your sacrifice there at the altar. Go and be reconciled with that person. Then come and offer your sacrifice to God. We can show our love to our parents and other grown-ups who take care of us by listening to their advice and treating them with love and kindness. They want what's best for us, so obeying them would be the wise thing to do.
We can show our love to our siblings and other family members by not filling ourselves with negative emotions toward them. It's understandable to get frustrated and annoyed sometimes. It's okay to feel hurt, but God doesn't want us to stay that way because it's more harmful to us. We can ask God to show us how to love them like God does and make things right with people who upset us. We can also show love to people we make a commitment to. Like when people get married, they keep promises we make to them. Our families aren't perfect, but God loves each of our family members anyway, and we can do the same.
Hey friends, so we are learning that we can love our families by putting love into action. And that means the way we act shows love, kindness, and respect. Let's read a Bible verse that explains this. We're going to be in 1 Thessalonians chapter 1, verses 2 through 7. We always thank God for all of you and pray for you constantly. As we pray to our God and Father about you, we think of your faithful work, your loving deeds, and the enduring hope you have because of our Lord Jesus Christ. Verse 4, we know, dear brothers and sisters, that God loves you and has chosen you to be his own people. For when we brought you the good news, it was not only with words, but also with power. For the Holy Spirit gave you full assurance that what we said was true. And you know of our concern for you by the way we lived when we were with you. So you received the message with joy from the Holy Spirit in spite of the severe suffering it brought you. In this way, you imitated both us and the Lord. Verse 7, as a result, you have become an example to all the believers in Greece. All right, so these verses tell us how Paul's friends loved each other through their actions. When we think about our families, hopefully we can see how they show us that they love us with their words and their actions. All right, so let's think about this. How has your family shown you that they love you lately? Have they given you like a really big hug? Have they played with you? Have they come home from a long day of work and still had the energy to play Fortnite? What about some things that we have done that may not be as loving towards our families? Have we maybe had a bad attitude? Maybe been a little sassy? Remember, we obey God by loving our families and showing them that we love them. Let's talk a little bit more about how we can do that with our memory verse. All right, are you standing? Let's stand up. Luke chapter 10, verse 27. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your strength, with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. Let's do it again. Luke chapter 10, verse 27. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your strength, with all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. Fantastic job. Y'all are so good. All right, let's be sure to check out the discussion questions at the end, and we will see you next time. Bye.